Hi there, and welcome to the weekly series on JavaScript ecosystem. Today we are going to look at how you can conditionally render a React component in your app. We will take a look at a very simple example in this video. Based on a condition, we will either render a component that displays the image of this coffee, or it'll render the image of a tea. So let's dive into the code. I'm using Code Sandbox here to spin up a React app. And inside this app.js file, I simply render this component with a text wrapped inside headline2. There are two PNG files I have added to the SRC directory, and this app component will render an image based on the value of this variable displayT. Its value is initially false. Now, our goal is to render the image of a T when displayT is true. Otherwise, we want to render the image of a coffee inside this component. In React, you can embed any expression in JSX if you wrap them in curly braces. And that's what we will do here. We will also use an inline if with a logical AND operator to ensure that the app component renders a T when displayT is true. Otherwise, it'll render the image of the coffee. This is a clever approach because of the way logical AND works. It evaluates from left to right. So if displayT is true, then your element on the right side of the logical AND will be the output. If displayT is false, then the element on the left side of the logical AND will be evaluated, which is false, so React is going to ignore it. To fix the errors, we will add the imports for both T and one for coffee. Let's also quickly add an inline style so that the height is 20 view height for both the images. Since the value of displayT variable is false, we see the coffee image being rendered. Let's go ahead and change the value to true. And you can see that the component is rendered with the image of T. So this is a pretty neat way of writing the code for conditional rendering rather than writing separate components to render two different images. However, if your component has a complex hierarchy, then it makes sense to abstract that code out into a smaller component. That's all I wanted to cover in this video. I hope that's helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.